A massive humanitarian effort begins in Turkey and in Syria following the strong magnitude 7.8 earthquake. Syrian state media reports planes carrying aid from Iraq and Iran landed at the Damascus airport early Tuesday. Officials from the quake-hit nations upped the death toll from the tremors on the same day to now at more than 4,300. The fatalities are still expected to rise as rescue efforts continue. Various countries have also mobilized teams to help the operations, while others have pledged millions of dollars for support. The chief of the United Nations has called the earthquakes devastating and urged more countries to send help.
I want to convey my deep sadness about the devastating earthquakes in Turkey and Syria. I extend my condolences to the families of the victims. The United Nations is mobilizing to support the emergency response, and so let's work together in solidarity to assist all those hit by this disaster, many of whom were already in dire need of humanitarian aid.
Turning now to the war in Ukraine, Russia said to be pouring reinforcements in the eastern part of the country ahead of an expected major offensive. The governor of the Luhansk province says more Russian troops are arriving in the area along with more weaponry. Moscow has concentrated its attacks on eastern Ukraine after it seized control of the town of Soledar last month. President Volodymyr Zelensky has vowed personnel changes in the military to bolster the country's defense against Russia. Kyiv is bracing for a major attack by Moscow to mark the first year of the war on February 24th. Speaking of the tensions in the Middle East, Israeli forces carry out a new raid in the West Bank, leaving at least five Palestinian militants killed. Monday's raid in the city of Jericho is the latest in the tensions between Israel and Palestine. Palestine's president has condemned the attack, while the Hamas's armed wing vowed to avenge the death of its members. Israeli forces have for months carried out raids in the West Bank following a series of deadly attacks in Israel last year. Its forces have also been put on high alert after a Palestinian gunman shot seven people dead at a synagogue in East Jerusalem. International experts join Chile's fight against massive wildfires as the fatalities from the forest fires climb to 26. Officials say hundreds are injured. Strong winds and high temperatures have caused the fires to spread throughout south of the country's capital. 50 firefighting experts, soldiers and drone pilots from Spain are in the country, as well as 150 military and civilian specialists from Mexico. Amid a new surge in temperatures, the U.S. sent in an air tanker to help out Chilean firefighters. Other countries that have pledged support include Argentina, Colombia and France. The Philippine Justice Secretary meets visiting United Nations Special Rapporteur Dr. Morris Tidball-Binns. Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla says the visit has nothing to do with the investigation into the alleged extrajudicial killings during the Duterte administration's bloody drug war. Johnson Manawat reports.
UN Special Rapporteur on extrajudicial killings, Dr. Morris Tidball-Binns, arrived early this morning at the office of the Philippine Justice Department here in Manila to meet with Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla and other officials of the Philippine government. Dr. Tidball-Binns will be in the country until Thursday, February 9, upon the invitation of Secretary Remulla. In an interview, Remulla clarified that Dr. Tidball-Binns is in the country not as a special rapporteur on EJK, but as an expert in the field of forensic pathology. According to Secretary Remulla, Dr. Tidball-Binns will be part of the capacity-building program of the government under the UNJP program. The UN Special Rapporteur's visit comes 2 weeks after the International Criminal Court moved to resume its investigation of the Duterte administration's war on drugs. Secretary Remulla adds this has nothing to do with Dr. Tidball-Binns' role as Special Rapporteur.
This is capacity building. No? It has nothing to do. This is not his SR status. No? This is for capacity building. He's an expert in forensic pathology. A field where we're lagging behind, unfortunately, because the pay of our doctors is not good in forensic pathology. And during the Yolanda tragedy, we had to rely on international experts to help us identify many of the bodies because we had no capability of identifying people through DNA and other means that are very, very much in the expertise of forensic pathology.
In the initial meeting, the DOJ include UN resident coordinator in the Philippines, Gustavo Gonzalez. Irmulia said he personally invited Dr. Tolbeans in November last year when they met in Geneva, Switzerland. Dr. Tolbeans was named Special Rapporteur in April 2021 after regional and global human rights programs for Amnesty International, the Inter-American Institute of Human Rights, Penal Reform International, and International Service for Human Rights.